Here our presentation on genomes. This is the problem that we are facing, and we are trying to find a better solution for it. Why is it important? As you can see, personalized genomics can change the world, and we're going to do that in maybe visually. Who is in our team? We have Dr. Kate Patterson, Heinrich, Justin, and Chair, and myself. And these are the roles that we play in that team. Our approach is to utilize game engines to engage users and to maximize our skill set. We divide the workflow into two engines, Minecraft and Unity, and we will use those two engines to put together the complexity of genomic data and create something really cool. This is our presentation for Michael, and I'll pass it to Justin.
Yeah, so what you can see here. As you can see here, we've got a Minecraft world. We're rendering a double helix, and to our right, we can see a protein that's attached to the helix. From here we can do other visualizations as well.
So we need more tools.
We'll continue this talk with Heinrich. He will speak them, and we'll talk about you.
So we also have to develop a transition from Maya, Autodesk Maya that Kate uses for animations. And we wanted to be able to show the same sort of structures, but in much more detail and with narration added. So in this example, you can actually navigate through a virtual world with your mouse, and then you can have proteins attached to the DNA strands, and you can sort of move to where you want to. You can click on it, and then you get a narration. Depending on where you go, you can actually get a different narration. You can move to nuclear zones. You can, for example, select it. And then you can also rotate it. You can manipulate it. This is just a proof of concept, so we basically only added a nuclear zone as well as a DNA strand, and then added a different narration based on which one you click on. And just to show, you can actually have an interactive demonstration of how different things work in the cell. And we had a few challenges that we had to overcome. We had to be able to navigate this world. We had to write that. We had to be able to, when you've changed direction, and then to move into that direction, you had to calculate the different vectors. That was quite a challenge. We had to figure out how to sort of make it look like you're inside a cell, so you have a background of chromosomes all around you. And one of the first challenges was effectively trying to get a common file format between what she was using and to get it into Unity, which is a game engine. So it's more accessible to people that, to children or to people that's familiar with the gaming world. Thank you.
These are the opportunities that we see with our project. It provides collaboration of knowledge and connectedness to advance the understanding of research. improve research function in genomes and exploit the full potential of solving major health problems, increase scientific literacy within that community, and save billions on the health budget through genome health care. Adding a gameplay ability to this project, you can inspire future generations to pursue science-based careers. He's our next step, sourcing funding and leadership from key stakeholders and building the Explore Your Genome project. And we've created an inspired team to explore the entire genome.
Thank you.
Goggles.
We want a member of the audience as a volunteer.
Is there any questions anyone would like to ask?
They got time.
No time for questions.